Yeah. First of all, I would like to say good afternoon to everyone here in the room and anyone joining us online. May I speak in Thai? เรียนท่านผู้อำนวยการประจำภูมิภาค
Regional Director and Representative of United Nations Industrial Development Organization, Mr. Stein Hansen, that he just gave the welcoming remark a minute ago. The Project Steering Committee of Global PH Program, and also Mr. Stephen Siga, the Director of Division of Circular Economy and Environmental Protection, UNIDO, and Ms. Geeta Sabharwal, UN Resident Coordinator. Thank you very much. And another important person, that is the senior expert on ILO in Asia Pacific region, Dr. Christina Martinez. Thank you all very much. And a second ago, we got the representative page secretariat from United Nations Environmental Program or UNEP, Mr. Adebiyi Odegbai, and gave us the great objectives and great example of PAGE program, distinguished participant, and all of the respected journalists who are attending the event on site and online, all the PAGE partner members. I'm very delighted that when I see the PAGE team partners, they are the new generation people join in this great activity. I'm very honored to be the chairperson for launching the Partnership for Action on Green Economy in Thailand, or PAGE, and the Project Steering Committee of Thailand, of what we call PAGE in Thailand, composed of NESDC, UNIDO, work with all of the partner agency, organized the launching event today. As everyone has said earlier, that the factors today, we face challenges on economy, that we just passed COVID-19 pandemic, and we face climate change, natural resource, water, soil, and environment that are our constraint. We need to revolutionize the use of natural resource in a just and fair manner, so that the next generation of people will be able to access the resource like we do, as long as the global population keep growing, if we still consume the resources as usual, the resources will never be adequate. Regardless of that, it will create the climate crisis. So this is the mission of our current population. When we encounter a problem, we all have to help contribute solving the problem. And Thailand, we incorporate in this, in the 13 National Economic and Social Development Plan. This is the mission that we need to work in the next 5 years. And is the milestone major. They are in the major milestone, in the milestone of improving the livelihood, the quality of life of people. Milestone number 4, to create country sustainability by reducing or focusing on decarbonization in line with the green economy. That is the main objective of our event today. At the same, the 5th milestone is preparedness for our country to cope with the climate change under the new global context in the 13th plan of Thailand, that Mr. Sika has talked about the 13th National Economic and Social Development Plan. Ms. Geeta and Dr. Christina have talked about BCG model. This is a new business model on the economy of Thailand. It's already incorporated in our 13th plan. This is the matter of biocircular green economy. We gonna work together concurrently to be in line with sustainable development goals achievement. And will be similar to UN, but will be a kind of partnership between public and private sector. But I would like to attach prominence to this matter because in Thailand, we have been working on this matter seriously, starting from many years ago in the year 1997 onward. We spent more than 600 billion baht or $20 billion on this matter, on working on this. And starting from what is shown on the screen, we start our BCG model a long time ago. All distinguished participants who are here and join us virtually, you might be able to carry on. We launched page program today, and then you might be able to carry on the existing projects that you have done. Allow me to explain to you briefly about this table of what we have been working. Everything is aligned, and this is a great example to show you that we can take the page activity immediately. Is the scope of BCG, starting from the small project that we implement at the community level as a community enterprise, and go all the way into the capital intensive programs. There are many things that are aligned with the page team members would like to implement. You may carry on or you may expand the existing projects. Many, many programs that we show you. The ECI WISTEC is working on the enzyme to solve the waste management issue. The waste segregation of Thailand has been working for a while, but we got a problem with the wet waste. We try to find one enzyme in order to really the digest the wet waste of food surplus to convert it to become biogas and residual will become fertilizer. The fertilizer that is not traditional fertilizer, but we gonna try to have it to be NPK fertilizer that can be used directly. So you may study for further information. Experiment has happened in a few provinces in Thailand already. If we solve the problem of wet waste or food surplus successfully, it's going to make the waste segregation of Thailand to be much easier. As the UN resident coordinator has covered, that's a great opportunity, especially for plastic waste. We have the program on circular economy in Rayong province. You may go to visit the project site there. We take the waste from household and separate in parts. The solid waste, they will separate and sell for recycling to create income. Instead of to be the liability or obligation, we turn it into the assets or revenue. This has been happening. This is 4 sites in Rayong province. We increase one more site in Nakhon Pathom province. If page program interested to expand, we might make it to become the project nationwide, and the waste collection is not the system that is designed. Everything is designed to be eco-friendly and to be environmentally friendly. Like we use the EV for the waste collection. So we use the electric vehicles for waste collection, and everything is operated by the online system, the household can find out the locations of the vehicles that will pick up the waste, and they can input the information, identify, and give the money back. This is an example of BCG model that has happened in Thailand. Definitely, we spend about several years to work on this. If we get the page to help us to expand the results, to materialize it, and to put technology, better technology and more funding, is going to make the thing that we think is slow, it will speed up. The hard thing will become easier. This is what I have listened to the keynote addresses from all experts. I am confident that if we have the paid team or paid activity going to the field, this will be expand with more efficiency. This is our hope to for the mitigate the global warming, and we're going to be able to use the resources effectively, and we're going to be able to build up momentum, and the momentum will create exponential effect, will be the multiplier, will not be the state linear effect anymore. This is my expectation, and I believe so does everyone. So this is what Thai people, not only Thai government, private sector, or including the new generation who start up their business, they contribute. And even at the large scale business, the recycling plants, they buy plastic waste and recycle, has been established in Thailand already. You may visit, the capacity is 30,000 tons for polyester resin, food grade, not packaging grade, food grade. And also there is the polyethylene recycle, more than 10,000 tons has happened in Thailand already. On the top of that, on the bioeconomy, we have bioplastics, and today the project, there are many plants in Thailand like polylipid acid resin, poly PBS, polybiosacinic resin, all of these are bioplastic that we will use. And in the near future, we're going to have bioethylene happen in Thailand. All of these will use the agricultural products, or will use agricultural products, mostly maybe from cassava or sugar. And I think we all know well that in the near future, the carbohydrate-based crops we will use less, and the protein-based crop will be used more. So we're gonna try to take all of these carbohydrate-based crop to produce environmentally friendly products. Paid teams may visit us. All of these projects, certain projects has been initiated already. Some projects are under the construction phase, and called protein. It might be linked to the protein base without using meat, animal meats anymore. If we talk about animal meats, is gonna be in another type of the greenhouse gas emission, then the multiplier effect will be higher than the normal carbon dioxide, because it's the methane emission matter. So it's much higher. And the tendency of the new generation, they are more of vegan vegetarians. So the acceptance of the new base protein, like the plant based protein or insect-based protein, can be developed further. Will be a lot of ample opportunities of new generation that we work at the community enterprise, SMEs, and involve thousands of people, involve 100,000 of farmers. So this will be another great opportunity that I would like Page team of us, that we will start today that we will start working today will be encouraged that you did not start from scratch, but you have challenging mission ahead of you. Not easy, very challenging that you have to work on, but you did not start from zero. You start from 10, but you need another 90 to achieve 100. We need all of you. So everyone has to work together, work harder.
Full intention.
With the full intention, commitment, engagement to achieve very challenging target. But once you achieve it, you're going to be very proud of your achievement, because this is not for us. This is for our future, next generation.
We bring in your...
It's very important to bring the pride to your mind.
But you know, I'm getting old now. I have two nephews already. So basically, my time is not as long as your, you know, page team. Okay, so I will do my best, okay, to support you. But I like to share this life, make it simple to make sure that it will provide an motivation, okay, and encouraging for everyone that hey. We must do it, and we can do it, and we can achieve it. Okay, because it's not start from zero. You have experts. You can talk to anyone. You know, you. I name everyone here. Okay, the name of the people or the company who are involved in the BCG at this moment is in there. Okay, that is something that you know Thailand is doing, but we need help. We need help. On technology, financing, and the market as well. And we would like to help the small guys, okay, the SME guy as well. I'm not worried on the big guy, like the BioLi family, you know, that capital intensive, let the big corporation to do it, okay? And in terms of the other, and in terms of the other, I'm doing, you know, bilingual.
I would like to share, please visit U-turn and other great example. Please visit WizTech. Please go to see the big scale plants. Please go to see the big temple called Wat Chak Dang. The chief of Buddhist monks there, that they use polyester to do the clothes of monks. And you say that the clothes of Buddhist monks, that thing is not cheap. I would like you to see these wonderful examples. So this is what I would like to show you, that is doable and it will create the ripple effect. It will, the effect is huge. Is nationwide. That is the way to create the big awareness, the big awareness to see the problem, to identify the problem and play a part of tackling the problem and make a decision to tackle the problem. And this has the huge value, more value than the present. I think some people understand it, but has not taken the action. If we help expand the project, they're all gonna contribute and the result will happen. Everyone will enjoy and make projects. It might be hard to be experienced by community people. We're gonna help contribute on working on page and the other green economy activities to achieve carbon neutrality and to have more renewable energy and to have community enterprise to have electricity generating plans to use solar energy, wind energy, including about electric vehicles and the other concerned matters. Thailand, we have far progress on these matters. I'm very convinced that EVs, electric vehicles, Thailand, We are at the forefront level. We just introduced the incentive program at the beginning of this year in order to help support Thai people to have experience of using EVs. So it's very successful. Let's say 15,000 EV cars have been booked already. It's not like we give them the grant. No, it's not like just for government spending, but this is a kind of incentivize them.
EV.
Anybody who would like to sell EVs, any companies that might sell EVs, the buyers will get discount, but the sellers will have commitment to build the manufacturing plants in Thailand. They have to build manufacturing plants in Thailand. It means that there are five companies that already decided to build the EV manufacturing plants in Thailand. So most recently is BYD company. Before that, there are Toyota, MG, many companies, and from European companies like Mercedes or BMW. They are interested to consider to involve in this mega project. Everyone view that Thailand has great potential on EVs, and not only EVs. So good EVs will need clean energy, electricity, or the power that we use in EVs must be the power from clean technology. So we try to increase more of clean energy. This is information for all of us, all the page partner members. 6 years from now on, we're going to have more clean energy, more than 10,000 megawatts of power, clean energy in many formats, starting from solar cell, solar plus battery storage, wind power,
hydropower,
biomass, and also biogas, everything will have the will be part of renewable energy to achieve the success on carbon neutrality of Thailand in the year 2050. So, frankly, I would like it to be faster. I think that if we work at the nationwide level, if we work on the bio and circular economy, like waste segregation, and also try to on the material recycling, and also the plant-based products, insect-based products, insect-based protein, if we can work in the wide scale, plus at the mega scale, I think we should be able to achieve faster than the year 2050, because what we are contemplating more and more is on the mega investment. That is what we call first the forest reforestation will help. The page team can help on the reforestation and on the capital intensive investment. The big corporations are working on carbon capture program. We are surveying on the something like the Thailand have the very high potential on the carbon storage in the soil, on geology. We visit Norway. There are the similar structure like Norway. I think we are even bigger than Norway. If we can store carbon under our soil for a large quantity, the carbon dioxide that we store, that we collect, like in the air, they can be collect and store under the earth. So that will be another interesting point in order to accelerate our goal of carbon neutrality achievement in Thailand faster than the year 2050. So what I have told you, what we need to accomplish and what we all need to contribute, not only for us only, but for our future generation, our children, our grandchildren, and for Thailand today. When I came here, Ms. Geeta asked me about how is the situation of global energy. I said that it's very hard, very tough. We are a dilemma. We have to decide whether we want to keep the fossil fuel or we want to go for another alternative energy source that is renewable energy, but the fossil is tough today. But it's still cheaper than renewable energy, so we need to make a tough decision.
You know, we have short term and long term. Basically, long term, we're going to go for renewable, definitely, because we cannot live with this kind of situation anymore. We don't want this kind of situation whereby we have to rely on imported energy at the any price. We cannot determine the price. So in the future, we have to be more self-sufficient so we can, you know, stand by our own feet. So basically, the energy sector have to focus more on the renewable, local, or the, you know, supporting from the neighboring country. That is our key purpose or the key objective of our new energy plan. นะครับ อันนี้ก็เป็นคำตอบสำหรับคุณกีตาร์ไปเลยนะครับ จะได
้ ครับ This is the answer for Ms. Geeta, so that doesn't need interpretation. Ms. Geeta asked me right in front of the room. So this is what I told you, that Thai government is so delighted what Page team has worked on. So we are very delighted to work with the UN agency, Ms. Christina, as well. You know, we are willing to work with you in every matters, and also our fellows from Switzerland and Germany. I have worked together with the European embassies who have interest on this. So I wish this project to be the project that is successful, to be the exchange forum. We all can contribute, at least the page team, page local team, or page global team, to know that Thailand is serious about it. We have strong determination, even though it might be difficult. It's not easy, but we believe that it's doable. And this is a great thing to do, so that Thailand will be the clean city, the lively city, and with the clean air and with the great environment that is friendly for everyone. So this is the strong determination, and we'll, along with the BCG model, along as the page program, the names might be different, but ultimate goals, the success are the same. So for this occasion, I would like to commend organizer, the UNIDO, NESDC, all the partner organization, and all the page team members who join us today. So today, I would like to launch this Partnership for Action on Green Economy in Thailand officially, and I wish this program to be successful and to achieve everything as all of you expect. And I wish everyone to play a part, develop all of this in the widest scope, create awareness, understanding, and the accessibility to what we are going to work on. And I believe that all of this, after people in the broad scale can experience, they will know the value of what we are creating, and will be the pride of everyone who joined this program for the benefit of people and the new generation in the future. Thank you very much.